What's good? What's good? Welcome to Epic Entertainment Critics. I'm Antoine.
And I'm still James.
And we are going to do an epic trailer reaction for Resident Evil Welcome to Raccoon City. We did one Saturday, and it didn't go up because of technical problems. So we're going to do this today, and we're going to just kind of do some discussion on it, just what we think about this trailer. I know people can't wait to hear it. So let's watch the trailer and then see what we got. So welcome to Raccoon City, Resident Evil.
Every story has a beginning. Discover the origin of evil.
Why are you back here, Claire? Your conspiracies weren't true when we were kids. They're not true now.
We need to expose Umbrella.
Watch this.
I'm afraid, Claire. I'm afraid of what they're gonna do to this town. You see, Umbrella, they had an incident. I'm talking Chernobyl, if you know what I mean. People are getting sick. You gotta help us, Claire. Let the world know what's really going on.
We have to contain this.
Trying to get up that great big hill of hope.
Shall we go?
For a destination. Into a crisis of times when I'm lying in bed. Just to get it all out. What's in my head? Looking at, I am feeling.
What were Umbrella doing here?
This is where they're experimenting on him.
We should split up.
What the? We gotta get out of here.
We're gonna take Umbrella down.
Exclusively in movie theaters, so it's not going to streaming. Yeah, that is Resident Evil, Welcome to Raccoon City. It's some stuff there that I'm looking at even after the second watching. I didn't notice the first time. But they are pretty much taking off both of the games, yeah. Right? One and two. Now, they start off with two.
Yeah, so I don't know if this is going to be like
In chronological order,
or if they're going to try to come up with some kind of, like, order of relevance.
Well, see, I feel like that you mentioned relevance. I feel like they're going to kind of push the side one.
Yeah.
Because it seemed like more on two.
Yeah.
And they're just going to give you a little bit on one.
And
you know,
I'm not sure how
they showed them getting to the mansion.
Yeah.
Which I was like, why can't they just do one and then do two?
Because I feel like this is them showing they don't have a lot of faith in getting a sequel.
It could be right. Like, we got to do both.
Because we see that a lot in these live action adaptations, right? Where it's like they don't think they can get enough rope to make enough movies to like actually stretch the story out, so they cram everything into one go.
Yeah, which right? is all usually a mistake.
Yeah, almost always a mistake.
But I think if they do just one, you don't need a big budget.
Because it's a compelling enough story.
It's a bottle film.
Also, it has the better story.
Yeah.
Like, I still think Resident Evil 2 is a better game than Resident Evil 1.
Right.
But Resident Evil 1 has the better story, you know.
But like you said, 2 was like a survival. 1 was to figure out what the hell's going on.
You know, like, because you don't know anything in 1. It's like, you come into what is effectively a rescue and recovery mission,
right? And then you start to see zombies, and then you got to figure out where the hell zombies coming from, what's happening here. That would make more sense because
Yeah, go ahead.
I would say because now with when you cramming both of them in there, it's going to be too much. So now we got to find out what's going on.
Yeah.
Then go through a whole city of this stuff going on. That would have been better for two.
Also, so much of two storyline assumes you know what's going on.
Right.
You know, so it's like you don't have to worry about where this thing come from because clearly it came from the virus.
I was just about to say, they banking on people not knowing, I mean, knowing already what's going on. But like, if you start from one, that would help the people that's not into the Resident Evil get into it because then they can kind of can figure out what's happening and then they can just follow the story as it go. But now, but I mean, I guess they'll start off with one. You know what they might do? The events of part one will be like the first 20 minutes.
Yeah.
And then next thing you know, they're going to end up in the city or whatever.
We'll probably see some folks show up later on and say, oh, yeah, I know all about this because I went through this.
Right. What you think of the mansion?
It should split up.
The way it looks. So this is definitely Warren. Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And, you know, then they jump back to two. So everybody remember those the staircase.
It's a bit smaller.
Yeah, it do look smaller, but they could have been.
They couldn't get a, you know.
Well, I'm saying it could have looked bigger in the game, but it do look.
I'm pretty sure it was bigger. well, because like if you remember, it's like there. It's
that budget real small.
It's got this grand staircase that branches out on both sides, and it curves grandly into the room.
Yeah.
You know, and it's like. It's not as big as, like, say, the Castle Dimitrescu in Resident Evil Village, but it was big. Like,
right.
This is like this one of those remote estates that rich people used to have all the time, you know. But this looks like this could be like on a street. I don't know, man.
Well, yeah, they're not 100% accurate, but all I've been wanting was a one. I wanted them to start off with one because
I think the entire time they were running that old Resident Evil movie franchise,
yeah,
like past the second one, they spent everything trying to find a way to fit stuff from the games in.
But they just give you an image of what was in the game, but it didn't make sense. Why
it didn't
it was
make
there.
Sense.
Like the dude with the hood with the big axe,
yeah,
like he was just there. Like, where'd he come from?
You know, it's like it had nothing to do with the game they took him from. Just he looked like the thing from that one game.
They could just say, "Oh, that's the one guy. That's that one guy." Whatever.
Pure fan service, no context.
Right.
I would hope with this we see a lot more context than fan service to the point of saying, you know, ride that line between adaptation and interpretation.
Right. So, I guess I what should I ask? What you think of the original movies? Did you like? Any of them?
I like the first two.
I like the first one.
Like, cause
after
like,
the first one, I was done.
Because like the second one took me a few years to start to enjoy. Because when I first saw it, I thought it was BS. I was offended. I left the theater like just mad. And then when I go I'm like.
The first one kind of gave you some elements of the game, but it wasn't the same plot. But it was kind of fun.
The
second one was just pure action.
It was pure action, and it was obvious. Yeah. You know, like. You can see like it taking cues from the action movies of the time. You know,
when she jumped through those stained glass with
the
motorcycle and then did
and then
a flip
shot,
off the motorcycle
flip,
and
shot
zombies
it.
In the air while she was flipping.
Oh,
like, my God. What are you doing here?
it was terrible. And like it's one of those movies where I was like, I know it's bad and I love it because it's bad now. Mm. But at the time, I was just like, why can't y'all get this right?
I was good on that.
But, like. The rest of the movies in that franchise, you can't even enjoy for being bad. Because at least the second
one. And you know what they did for part one, though, the original Resident Evil? Mm. They gave a newspaper clipping. They was like, oh, a lone cop survives the mansion, whatever. And then Jill Valentine showed up at the police station and shot some zombies. This is how you kill them, y'all. And I'm like, oh, goodness.
Hey, but look, at least they eventually gave us our boy Mike Epps.
Yeah,
with his custom pistol.
Right, yeah, some gold guns. So this is the new Jill here. What's her name?
Hannah John Kamen.
So this is the new Jill. I like Jill from the original game.
Yeah.
I mean, because I'm a fan of the original game.
Yeah.
So I'm closer to those original characters. Yeah. Those characters. She don't look like her, but
I'm not.
Are you okay with the race swap?
I mean
she. She's biracial.
She's biracial. It's not like, it's not an essential
right
character trait.
They pushed Jill to the side so much for, what's her name? Alice? Wasn't it Alice?
Alice, yeah.
Yeah, it's like, which is nobody, character. She's not even a character from the game.
Yeah.
So it's like, Jill was like barely in the movies.
Yeah.
And then a lot of people don't even know about Jill for real, but Jill was the original protagonist.
Well, like,
Jill or Chris.
They sprinkled a little bit of, I think everyone, yeah, all the protagonists show up at some point in the franchise.
Yeah.
They usually end up dying.
Oh, you're talking about in the movies?
In the movies.
Yeah, we're gonna leave that. We're gonna tell you the movies.
Yeah, yeah. The thing I will say about those is when they did that, they're like, okay, you don't need to be able to play the character. We just need people to be able to look at you and see the character.
Yeah, like the dude playing Wesker.
Like, the dude playing Wesker was horrible, but
he looks just like Wesker.
You know, when they brought in, I forget who they had playing Chris, but he looked just like Chris.
Right.
So it's like they were just looking at fan service. Like, this. It looks like they're actually trying to tell a story.
So, right. So, I think what they promised to do is to be faithful to the games.
Faithful rather than accurate.
Right. But my problem is pick one. I don't like them meshing both of them. Maybe they feel like it wasn't enough material in neither one.
Then clearly they didn't finish the game.
I know them games long. Yeah. So, I mean, I guess they feel like that's too long to be stuck in a facility with people. But they've done it before.
I will say also, like, I can see the knee-jerk reaction of, like, part of the reason why you're stuck in this one location is because, like, you got to go back and forth so much in the game. But I'm like, you can just stretch some of that stuff out and make it flow.
But we know these take place at different times. So
that's
I'm curious to see how they're going to do it.
Like, there's a decent gap between the two.
Right, because they go to the compound and find out what's going on, whatever.
Yeah.
And somehow the viruses are going to get out of the compound and it's going to get into Raccoon City.
Yeah. I think it's like a bat or a bird or something makes it into Raccoon City and starts infecting stuff.
Right. So, yeah, and then let's talk about, you know, on part two, we got things like Mr. X.
So that's the other thing. Is he going to show up?
Yeah, I don't see how they're going to make him. Well, I guess, you know what, I was like, how is Mr. X going to show up without people thinking, like, really? But then you got the liquors, and then you got the eye thing. Let me see if I can find it. The thing, if you're going to have that, where the thing with the eyes? If you're going to have that, man,
it
then you can.
Earlier in there.
I thought I saw it towards the end. There
So, like, I'm thinking.
Gross.
Because, like, when Mr. X starts, like, mutating way out.
So, is that Mr. X
mutating? He does that. But also, what's his name? One of the scientists, I think, ends up giving himself a version of that of the T virus, and he ends up turning.
He turns into that thing with all the eyes.
Yeah.
That's probably what it is.
Yeah.
So it's gonna go all the way up from part two or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got the liquors. I hate the liquors.
Who don't?
You got to kill them with a shotgun.
Like,
but it's like their brain is on the outside. It's like,
they
should be easy to kill.
For whatever reason, the shit, like, they got the hardest brains on the planet.
Ew. But yeah, they should be easy to kill. Their brains is on the outside. But nope, it's hard to kill them.
Bad enough, it's hard to get a bead on them.
Yeah, I know. But yeah, it looks good. I mean, because it looks like if you're a fan of the game, it's going to got everything you want. But the problem is, are they just going to replay the cutscenes?
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. You got to make it flow narratively.
If it doesn't flow, then it's just like, okay, so you previs some cutscenes, and then you put some effects on them. So now
and that was the problem they was having with, what's that, the Tomb Raider movie?
Yeah.
Where it was cool scenes, but that's just like the cutscene.
So
you just showed me a live-action version of the cutscene, which is like, if you do that, it's like, I could just watch the cutscene and get more enjoyment for that.
It'll probably be better.
Yeah. So we'll see, man. I hope it's gonna be good. I got high hopes, and I'm happy they actually going the route of left that other movie behind and let's go on with the games. I'm happy where they're doing it, but I still
like, it is a shame the Wesker they got now looks so un-Wesker-ish.
Well, let's see what he do, because they had Wesker in some of the later games. He's just such a badass.
Yeah.
Like, it's like he's so superhuman. And I played the remake of part one. And I'm like, Wesker was part of the original team. Yeah. I was like, I forgot.
Yeah, he was a commander.
Like, yeah, I think, I guess. I thought it was Barry.
Still wearing his goddamn shades all the time.
Right. Like, why are you so cool? Like, why you wear shades?
No one needs to be this cool, man.
Was he, like, augmented? Or was he, like,
I don't know if he was augmented.
Enhanced or something?
I don't know if he was augmented yet. I don't know. Okay. Because his storyline is a little convoluted.
Yeah, yeah. I just always seen from the cutscenes just come in and, like, do some real badass stuff. And then, like, and shades never come off. But,
like, this is one of the things where Resident Evil has always, like, been super unrealistic. Like, Chris has always been a little too strong for a normal human being. Mm-hmm. Leon has always been a little too agile for a normal human being.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like they just they give them protagonist syndrome and let them go.
Yeah. So we'll see. We'll see. It looks like it's going to be the first two movies, and then they probably the next movie.
And
if
God
it's
help
successful.
Us if they cram more in.
Right. Don't do that. If it's successful, then you go to Nemesis.
Yeah.
Don't just try to give us Nemesis on this.
Yeah.
If Nemesis show up at the end, I'm like, oh, yeah, I messed up.
Yeah.
I mean, because it's already a lot to swallow to begin with.
Exactly.
That's why you got to learn how to start off slow with baby steps.
Well, like, that's the other thing with adaptation in general, right? It's like, you either assume everyone knows what you're talking about, like when you're talking about big IPs like Batman and Superman, we all know the story, so we don't need spoon-fed to us. Or you understand that it's a niche property, and you let people into it easy enough.
Right, but they don't, boy, they just got to show this. They got to show that.
So, like, the fan
remember service, this, huh? Yeah, remember this?
The fan service route like gets people who play the games in, but people who didn't is like, ooh, what is that?
Yeah. So anyway, that is our reaction discussion for Resident Evil: Welcome to Raccoon City.
Looks real interesting.
If you still watching, if you like our videos, you like our content, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you get alerts every time we post a new video or if we live stream.
And if you like what you've seen here today, hit that thumbs up. Let YouTube know that we're doing something right. And drop a comment down below. What's your favorite Resident Evil game? And what would you like to see us react to next?
Yes, we out of here.
Peace, y'all.